bless the nations, Father. Thank you, Father. Another word. Though the mountains may move and the hills shake, my love will not be removed from you, and my covenant of peace shall not be shaken, says your compassionate Lord. Thank you, Lord, for being compassionate. Thank you for loving us, Father. Thank you for your peace. Just we ask that peace be broadcasted out into the atmosphere around us, Father, and that you will just stir up the people, Lord, for your word and hunger for you, Father. Trust you, Lord. Thank you. I ask that you guys pray for the nations. I keep getting nations. Pray for the nations. Something's being stirred up. So just pray. God's will be done. I know it will always be done, but I just send up a special prayer for the nations right now, Father. The turmoil that's going on in the Middle East, Father. I just ask that your hand be upon them as they make their decisions, Lord. And come quickly, Jesus. All right, ladies, the sun's rising. Let's pray for the requests. And finish up.
Thank you, Father.
Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We come today before you with our hearts, Lord. We thank you for thank you for your presence. Thank you for being here with us and touching our hearts and changing things and helping us to give all the things to you, Father, that we lay down on the cross. I ask that you just bless the rest of this time together, Lord, and that we lift up the requests of all of our hearts and petitions that we intercede for, Lord, on people's behalf and ourselves. We just ask that. And we thank you that you just take care of them. We trust you with them, Father. So we leave them with you right now, Father. Lift them up. You guys got anything special on your hearts? Father, we lift up these prayers that were spoken right now, Father, to you. All of the needs that we have expressed, from healings to white blood cells counts coming up, and all the people that have been mentioned, Lord, we just thank you. We lift them up and praise your holy name that you're gonna do miracles, and we're gonna hear reports, Father, of things changing from this point forward. We're gonna see your hand in all of these prayer requests, Father. We just thank you so much, Lord, and I ask also that you especially just bless these two right here, Father, and just give them an extra measure of peace
hope and joy today, Father. Fill up their hearts, and we lift up Pastor Anthony as well as our leader and their relationship and everything that he struggles with, Father, and we just ask that you guard him, set up angels around him, Father, that you will protect him from any advances that might start to come against him as he prepares for this Sunday, Father, to preach your word to your children and to feed us, Lord, and to hold down this mighty fort that you have given us, Father, and this place of worship, and just help him, guide him, give him wisdom and discernment. And we just lift up all the people in the church as well, Father, that we have that come and that aren't coming, that are at home, that are struggling with anything, Father. We ask that you cover them as well, Father, and bless the city. And as we speak to the east, let's go for that, where we see your sun rising over here, Father. We feel the warmth of the sun in our bodies, Lord, so I ask that you comfort and give that same peace and that warm cleansing, just calmness about you that you bring to people, that when people line up with your will, Father, in the east, that they will feel the peace and the presence of God when they make decisions today, Father, when business decisions are made, with decisions for family, anybody that's in court, anybody that's struggling with their relationship with you, Father. Anybody in this way, we just pray, Father, we pray for more people to come from the east as well, Father, and for people that are on the streets to find help and to find food and shelter and jobs, Lord, for all of the people in the east. And we also turn to the west, Lord, and we know that you're going to do a great work in this direction, Father. We know that you're just going to miraculously touch and heal people in this direction, Father, with cancer, the depression, the spirit of addiction, alcoholism, abuse, Father, anything that's in this direction that is a stronghold for the people in the West, Father, that you will just break it off right now in Jesus' name, and you will free them of their bondages, Lord. We also call forth strong leaders to come from the West, Father, into your church, and we ask for a move to start happening over in that direction, Father, a stirring of the Spirit and a cleansing of the hearts, Father, and worshipers will start to arise, Father, and start to walk in victory, Father. We turn to the north. Oh, north, we speak. We ask that your Spirit rests over the north and that it will start to move and touch lives and change lives in this direction. Comfort those that are struggling. Comfort those that are in need. Comfort those that feel alone. Bring them into your houses, Lord. Bring them here. Bring them into a church, Father. Bring them back, all the backsliders in this direction in the north. We speak to them and we ask that you turn them back to you and bring them. Any prodigal sons in this direction or daughters that are out there just wandering, throwing their money away on useless things, Father, we ask that you bring them back to mom and dad, into their families, and let them be received well. And to the south, to the beach cities, the beautiful coastline, Father, the revival that's coming from the south, Father, that is brewing right now and bubbling up in your spirit, that is alive, and that tidal wave of grace that's coming, Father, we ask that you release that anointing right now, Father, that you release it from the churches and you start to speak revival into the hearts, but not just say, oh, revival is coming, but revival is here now, Father. We ask that you stir that spirit up in all the directions, Father, that revival is here now. It's not coming. It is in the moment, and we will move forth, Father, in this direction, Father, that it will start to come over, and the revival will go all the way back to the Holy Land. Father, we ask that you move quickly, Father. Change the hearts. Bring the people and the leaders that need to come together to help make this possible in this area so that we can join what is going to happen. And I ask for protection for all the directions and all the churches as the revival comes and the grace starts to pour out and the attacks, that we will be mighty proud and strong and boast in your name, Lord, and we will get in your house and we will pray together and not be afraid, Father. So we thank you for that, Lord. Is there anything else, ladies? In Jesus' name, we pray for those, and then I'm going to get to the prayer request real quick. You guys can get going.
So, Lord, to all these prayer requests, I ask that you put your hand on them. Father, I'm going to speak them each individually, but as a whole, Lord, as these people have stepped out in faith, that we will agree with them in prayer, Father, that you will move on their behalf and answer every single one of these in quick time, Father, in days, in weeks, no further than that, Lord. We ask that we lift up Robert and to open the doors for his move and to restore his spiritual life. So he wants to move, Father. He wants a new place, Father, of residence, Lord, and also a move of the Spirit on his heart, Lord. He's asking for spiritual revival, Lord. I ask that you just wake him up, stir him up right now, even now, Father, as we speak, that he will just feel your Holy Spirit hit him and start to seek and to thirst after you. And Guy, his brother Al, has liver cancer. We ask that that be gone in Jesus' name. Cancer be gone. We rebuke you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. The name above all names, your name, Father, that is bigger than cancer. It will be gone, Father. Thank you, Father. And for Daniel, new baby for Daniel. And no complications, Father. I also ask that you bring Daniel and his wife into this church, Father, that they stop saying that they're going to come sometime, that you will actually bring them in here. They will walk in and we will be able to lay hands on them and bless this new baby and anoint their whole family with your Holy Spirit, Father. We also speak to Majid from his place. He's been talking about selling his house and he's actually feels the call to do that, so we ask that you give him wisdom and knowledge in that area, Father, to sell the house and someone to write the contract and safe travel and wisdom on the planning to move to Egypt. And I ask that you bless him and his wife's ministry, Father, as they teach and they preach and proclaim the word in that dangerous area, Father, that you cover them with your angels, that they're fine and safe. And I just lift up Majid's heart for his support for his wife as a missionary. Thank you so much for that family. Christian, revival in the Philippines. He's asking for the same thing as we just spoke here, Father. Revival now, not later, Father. Revival now, not later, Father. So move. And we agree with him in Jesus' name that more souls are going to be brought into your kingdom and saved from eternal damnation, Father. We ask and we pray that you do this. And for Perez, we lifted her up and we lift her up again, Father, that she needs a job. She needs to support her kids and then help her with the strength to help her mother and to care for her mother as her mother gets well, Father. And I ask that you help her faith to arise, Father, and that she will not feel like she is needy or she has lack, that she will trust in your word, that you're going to provide a miraculous job hiring and provision making, that she can just bless other people, Father, and just believe, Lord. We ask that she turns to you, Father, not to mammon, Father. And we also lift up Setchum, or you know the name, Father, the weakness that she feels, Father, in her bones and in her body and her relationship, Father, that she feels and she struggles and she puts herself out there, Father, hoping that her husband will pay attention to her, Lord. I ask that he turns his eyes towards her, Lord, and that she will feel the relationship start to be restored from this point forward. And we ask that your will, Lord, which we know will be done, but show her what your will is for her life. Give her visions and revelation and steps to step in that she can see and follow, Father. We also lift up Evasia, and the false allegations of the 9-year-old that was made against the family, Father. I ask that the truth be restored and the truth be brought out, Father, and that she will rethink and take those words back, Father, that you will correct any damage that's been done in that situation, Father, because truth will prevail. You are a righteous God, and no evil shall befall that whole family because of this, Father. We also lift up Julie, sweet Julie, and her spirit, Lord, and her thirst and her hunger to do right, Father, and all the struggles that she has with her past, you know, demons and things that go through her head of, I'm not worthy, I can't do this, oh God, if you give me this, that I'm going to mess it up. No, Father, she's working, she's seeking you, Lord, she's doing the things that she needs to do, Father. So we ask that you bring her kids back, Father, and that you bless this relationship, Lord, that you had bestowed on us last night, Father, and you turned hearts together and you put hearts as one, Father, and that you will just use us in a mighty way, Father. I lift our relationship up, Lord, and our just coming closer to you, that we will glorify you in anything that's going to go on with the courts today, any decisions that are made. We ask, we already prayed for, and we just keep trusting you, Father. 30 days with half, with a 3-day kick, so she'll be out on the 19th, Father. We also lift up Carmen. She had two prayer requests that I don't know why she didn't send them, but you know what she needs, Father. I know that she's looking to move here to be with us and help for her daughter, Lord. So we ask that you do that, Lord, and that you get her here, Father, and you open up a way and you make a way and you just give her strength, Father. And also ask that you help her to rest, Father, to get some sleep, that maybe the baby will sleep peacefully for some hours and that she will be able to relax and just take some time for herself, Father. Restore a right spirit in her, Lord. Fill her up with more joy and get her here. In Jesus' name, we thank you for all of these requests. We thank you for today. We thank you for just listening and that we can even come to you, Lord. And I just ask that you, Father, be blessed by the fact that we're here in honor of you. And we believe in you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father. So that, and any time that you guys have anything, you can reach us all the time. Call the prayer line. You know where to find us on the internet. But if you can't, just call 1-844-PRAYERS with a Z. And we'll pray with you in agreement, believing that we stand together on anything, as God's word says, it will be done. Anything that we agree on here on earth, it will be done. As it happens in the spiritual realm first, so shall it be here. And I thank you for tuning in. And I thank you for your faith. I thank you for your prayers. And I thank you for everything that you do to be a part of this ministry, even though you're not here with us right now. We love you and we appreciate you and we care for you deeply. Until we meet in person, be blessed in Jesus' name. Good day.